Hello students, welcome to the lesson based on sentence structures. Today we are going to learn about sentence types. Now the different kinds of sentences that we are going to learn about today are simple sentences, compound sentences, complex sentences and compound complex sentences. This is a very important topic right up to the 12th standard. So you need to know individually what the definition of each kind of sentence. For example, what is the basic element of every sentence? Well, every sentence is made up of a subject and a predicate. Here, Mary plays tennis is the sentence. So in this sentence, the doer of the action is Mary. Mary plays tennis. So the subject is Mary and the predicate is plays tennis. Now, one thing to remember is that we never have a verb in the subject. Okay, the subject is the doer of the action. Now, we come to simple sentence. What is a simple sentence? A simple sentence has only one subject and one predicate. A simple sentence is one which has only one finite verb. Okay, and what is the meaning of a finite verb? A finite verb is one that is limited by person or number. Now, person is first person, second person, third person, and number is singular or plural. Now, simple sentence. An example of simple sentence is, we went to San Juan yesterday. Now, in this, we is the subject and went to San Juan yesterday is the predicate. Now we look at the sentence. We is a pronoun and that is the simple subject. The verb is went and to San Juan, that is the predicate. So went to San Juan is the complete predicate and to San Juan is prepositional phrase. It's a phrase. To is the preposition. So the words along with the preposition is called as the prepositional phrase. Now let us look at the previous sentence. Mary plays tennis. So a simple sentence contains one subject and one predicate. Then we look at another sentence here. This too is a simple sentence. Tom and Mary play tennis and swim. So here we have not a simple subject, but we have a compound subject. That means two. It is made up of Tom and Mary. So it is a compound subject and plays tennis and swim. Play tennis and swim. That means both of them play tennis and they swim. So here we have a compound predicate. That means they are giving us two different activities. A simple sentence with a compound subject and compound predicate. Tom and Mary, they are two people, right? So it is compound subject and they participate in two different activities, that is play tennis and swim. So you have compound subject and compound predicate, that too makes up a simple sentence. Now we have finished with what a simple sentence is. Now we go on to see what is the compound sentence. Now a compound sentence has more than one part that can stand alone. That means it has two independent clauses. Independent clauses are connected by coordinating conjunctions, conjunctive adverbs or a semicolon. So these are the three important things for you to keep in mind: coordinating conjunctions, conjunctive adverbs or a semicolon, that is yes, a punctuation mark. Now, the first example of a compound sentence is, we went to San Juan and most of us danced all night. So, which are the two parts of the sentence? We went to San Juan, that is one independent clause. Most of us danced all night. So, both these parts of the sentence are able to stand on their own. And the coordinating conjunction that links both these independent clauses is and. Now we will just look at this in detail. We went to San Juan and most of us danced all night. So what is we? We is the subject and went to San Juan is the predicate. And in the next independent clause, we have most of us is the subject, danced all night. That is the predicate. So here you have two independent clauses. So there are two subjects and two predicates. And both of them are connected by the coordinating conjunction and. Then the next compound sentence, how do we use of coordinating conjunction? So you have one subject and predicate, and then you have a coordinating conjunction linking another subject and predicate. Tom swims and Mary plays tennis. So here this is a compound sentence because Tom is the subject, swims, that is the verb. So that is one complete part of the sentence. That's an independent clause. And Mary is the subject and plays tennis is the predicate. So you have two independent clauses being joined by the coordinating conjunction and. Now let us have a look at the list of coordinating conjunctions. And they are for, and, nor, but, or, yet, and so. Now if you look at it, they form an acronym, and that is FANBOYS, FANBOYS. F for for, A for and, N for nor, B for but, O for or, Y for yet, and S for so. So we will look at the acronym that it forms. So Tom swims and Mary plays tennis. So as I said earlier, Tom is the subject, swims is the predicate. Mary is the subject and plays tennis is the predicate. So both these are independent clauses and they are joined by the coordinating conjunction and. Then the next, say in this again, let us have a look. The Tom swims and then we put a comma before the coordinating conjunction. So a comma is used before and in a compound sentence. Now in a compound sentence, we can join the two independent clauses not just by coordinating conjunctions, which is FANBOYS, but we can also use conjunctive adverbs. Now conjunctive adverbs are made of two verbs, more and over, how and ever, other and wise, there and for. So you join them together, that's why they are called conjunctive, means they are joined by using an adverb and using a conjunction. So more, over, however, otherwise, and therefore. So these are called conjunctive adverbs. Now we will look at a sentence where we use we join two independent clauses with a conjunctive adverb. Bob is handsome, moreover he is rich. Now moreover is the conjunctive adverb, and Bob is handsome is one independent clause, he is rich is the other independent clause. So always remember, in a compound sentence you will have two independent clauses joined by connectors. Now Bob is handsome, then you have a semicolon, moreover he is rich. So semicolon before the conjunctive adverb and comma after the conjunctive adverb. So this is the way you need to write the sentence. Conjunctive adverbs float. Now this is for you to give you a visual picture of exactly how it works. Conjunctive adverbs are called floating adverbs because they can be positioned at the beginning, in the middle of the sentence, or even at the end of a clause. Once again I repeat, conjunctive adverbs float. They are called floating adverbs because they can be positioned at the beginning of the sentence, in the middle of the sentence, or at the end of a clause. Let's see how it works. Now, conjunctive adverb at the beginning, in the middle, and at the end. In the first sentence, Bob is handsome, then you put a semicolon and then you write moreover, comma, he is rich. Then in the second sentence, Bob is handsome, semicolon, he is, moreover, rich. That means it comes in the middle of the next independent clause. And in the third one, Bob is handsome, semicolon, he is rich, comma, moreover. That means you're saying the same things, but you're making use of the conjunctive adverb in three different ways. Okay, one is in the center, one is at the end, and one is again in the middle. One is at the beginning of that independent clause. So these are three different positions in which we use the conjunctive adverb. Now, a compound sentence, how can you connect it with a semicolon? Tom has benefited from his exercise program. He is slim and energetic. So without using a conjunctive adverb or a coordinating conjunction, you can just join it by using a semicolon. Tom has benefited why? From his exercise program. He is slim and energetic. Now, we go to the third kind of sentence, and that is a complex sentence. So, a complex sentence has at least two parts. One that can stand alone, that is an independent clause, and the other part that cannot stand alone, and that is called the dependent clause. So, the part that cannot stand alone is linked to the rest of the sentence by a subordinating conjunction. So, a complex sentence is one which consists of one main clause and one or more subordinate clauses, depending upon the full meaning of the main clause. So again, I repeat, a complex sentence has two or three parts or even four parts, but one is an independent clause and the other clauses are dependent clauses. So let us have a look at the example. Since my boyfriend and I wanted to have fun, we went to San Juan yesterday. So now over here, let us analyze this sentence. Now, we went to San Juan yesterday. So this part of the sentence is the independent clause. As we can understand, you get a complete picture that two people went to San Juan yesterday. And if you read the first part of the sentence, since my boyfriend and I wanted to have fun, so this part of the sentence, wanted to have fun, so what? So that means this part of the sentence is not able to stand on its own, so it's called a dependent clause. Now over here, since we wanted to have fun, since is a coordinating conjunction and it cannot stand alone, and also it does not make complete sense, whereas the second part of it, we went to San Juan yesterday. So San Juan, so this whole part is an independent clause and the first part of it is dependent upon it. Now you have a complex sentence where you have subject and predicate and then being joined by the subordinating conjunction, even though, so you have two clauses, one is an independent clause and the other one is a dependent clause. Now the example of that, Bob is popular even though he is ugly. So how do we read it? Bob is popular. Now this part of the sentence is an independent clause and we can understand clearly it's able to stand on its own. If you say Bob is popular, I mean the sense of the sentence is completely clear that Bob is popular. I mean it's like there's no doubt in anyone's mind. But suppose I say even though he is ugly, then you will wonder in your mind that even though is ugly, what? So this part of the sentence is called dependent clause. It is unable to stand on its own and it is dependent upon the other part of the sentence, that is Bob is popular. Now all the subordinating conjunctions, we have a complete list over here. Now you must study these subordinating conjunctions by heart. The most common ones are, now we will go, all this is in alphabetical order. So if you write it a couple of times, you will be able to remember. After, although, as. So there are three. Then three A's. And then because and before. Two B's. And then how, if, once, since, than, that, though, till, until, when, where, whether, and while. So there are four W's in it. So if you just make sure you just revise them. Fanboys is very easy to remember, right? Starting with for and ending with S, that is so. So that one is simple. And then all the other remaining ones over here, you must make these two lists and study them thoroughly. Now we come to the example of complex sentences where we use subordinating conjunctions. Bob is popular even though he is ugly. So, which is the independent clause? Bob is popular. And even though is a subordinating conjunction. Even though he is ugly. So, this is the dependent part of the dependent clause, which is dependent upon the independent clause. Now, even though Bob is ugly, he is popular. Now, if we write it like this, then the whole meaning changes. Now, suppose we say, even though Bob is ugly. So, this part of the sentence becomes a dependent clause. And here, he is popular means Bob is popular. So, that is still the independent clause. So, when we say, even though Bob is ugly, it does not make complete sense. So, this part here is the subordinate clause. It's the dependent clause. Now we come to the fourth type, compound complex sentence. That means it is a complex and a compound sentence together. You have two parts. That means there are two clauses that are independent, and there is another clause which is dependent clause or a subordinate clause. So dependent and subordinate, they mean one and the same thing. Now, compound complex sentence. This type of sentence has more than one part that can stand alone. That means more than one, maybe two, and at least one part that cannot. That means the parts that can stand alone are called independent clauses, and the part that cannot stand alone is known as dependent clause or subordinate clause. They mean one and the same thing. So conjunctions link the different parts of this sentence. So let us look at an example, then it will be clearer in our mind. Since we wanted to have fun, my boyfriend and I went to San Juan yesterday and we danced all night. Now, let us look at this part of the sentence. We danced all night. That makes the sentence, means the meaning of that sentence completely clear. We danced all night. So you understood that, yes, we danced all night. So that is one independent clause. Then, my boyfriend and I, that is compound subject, we went to San Juan yesterday. That is also an independent clause. So, the two independent clauses are, we danced all night, my boyfriend and I went to San Juan yesterday. So, these are the two independent clauses joined by the coordinating conjunction and. And since we wanted to have fun, what does that mean? We do not know. Since you wanted to have fun, what? So, this part of the sentence is called dependent clause, or it's called the subordinate clause. So, and since is a subordinating conjunction. So, this word makes it a dependent clause. So, in this sentence, we have two independent clauses and one dependent clause. So, this is called a compound complex sentence. Then, here, just now, this is the explanation of what I said just now. Since we wanted to have fun is the since is the subordinating conjunction, and it is that part that cannot stand alone. My boyfriend and I is the subject, but it's a compound subject. Went is the verb, to San Juan is the went to San Juan is the predicate, and then the next we have a coordinating conjunction and we is again the subject, and danced all night is another predicate. So the second and the third part of the sentence, they are independent clauses. So, this makes a compound complex sentence. Again, another sentence. Mike is popular because he is good looking, but he is not very happy. So, over here, let us look at, analyze each part of that sentence. Mike is popular. This, the sense of the sentence, it makes complete sense. Mike is popular. Correct. He is good looking. But which is the coordinating conjunction? But he is not very happy. So Mike is popular, and but he is not very happy, that is the coordinating conjunction. So he is not very happy is the independent clause, and Mike is popular also is an independent clause. Now when we say because he is good looking, that part of the sentence is the subordinate clause, so it is not able to stand on its own. So here we have Mike is popular, he is not very happy. So these are the two independent clauses joined by a coordinating conjunction but, and the subordinating conjunction is because. So yes, this is the last slide, but again children, I just want to revise a few sentences with you. Now, simple sentence, as I said, a simple sentence is one which has only one subject and one predicate. For example, true lovers of mankind are rare in this world. So, true lovers of mankind is the subject and are rare in this world is the predicate. Then let us go to compound sentence. A compound sentence is one which is made up of two or more coordinate clauses joined by a coordinating conjunction. For example, the sun was setting and we were still away from our destination. The sun was setting is one independent clause, and we were still away from our destination is the other independent clause joined by the coordinating conjunction and. Then the rain fell, the lightning flashed, and the fierce wind blew. So here the rain fell, the lightning flashed is the independent clause, and the fierce wind blew and is the coordinating conjunction. So then we go to the last part of the sentences, that is the complex sentence. A complex sentence is one which contains of one main clause and one or more subordinate clauses. For example, do not count your chickens until they are hatched. Do not count your chickens is the independent clause. It's able to stand on its own, and until they are hatched does not make complete sense. So it is the dependent clause. Then, as we tried to enter the hotel, the manager said that there was no room. So here, the manager said, as we tried to enter the hotel is the dependent clause. The manager said that there was no room. So this is the independent clause, and it's able to stand on its own. So children, I hope you have understood the concept of simple, compound, complex and compound complex sentences well, because after you learn and understand this part well, make sure you make the two list of two conjunctions, subordinating and coordinating, and learn them thoroughly. Then we will go on to the next topic, transforming from one, that means from one simple to compound, compound to complex, and so on. So you need to know all these concepts, need to be clear in your mind. So have a nice day.